We were looking for a way to create a gene therapy that would enable photoreceptors to survive longer. Unfortunately, there are many disease genes which lead to the death of the photoreceptors. If you're in a family which has a disease gene which affects the photoreceptors, for almost every case, you will go blind. So we've been studying this, trying to understand, well, why do the photoreceptors die? And is there a way to stop them from dying? So one of the things that we know is that photoreceptors are damaged by high oxygen that's coming into the eye. So our idea was to then stop the cells from getting the kinds of damage that one gets from too much oxygen by supplying genes that normally combat this problem. So people who inherit disease genes which affect the rods and the cones, the photoreceptors, one subset of those individuals have a disease called retinitis pigmentosa.
So in this study, we included three mouse models of retinitis pigmentosa.
And they have the same disease genes as humans, and they have the same progression of the disease.
The method we used in this study is to use a virus vector called adeno-associated virus and to deliver antioxidant genes to the mouse eye.
And then we asked, do the photoreceptors live longer? And can the mice see better?
What we found is that we can prolong cone survival and also prolong their visual function.
So we're very happy to see that cone photoreceptors, this is the cell type that gives us our daylight color vision and our high acuity vision. Cone photoreceptors are the cells we really wanted to save with these treatments. And it looks as if NRF2 in particular, but SOD2 and catalase as well, had great effects in terms of preserving the survival and the function of these cone photoreceptors. And this gives us hope that this will continue to work as we go and test in larger animals and hopefully eventually in people.